Ever seen a resistor go from fine to firecracker in under a second? In this video, I'll show you exactly why that happens, and the simple tricks pros use so their parts run cool, safely, and reliably for years. I've got a 9-volt battery and a 10-ohm resistor. When I attach the alligator clips to the leads, current rushes in. There's the spark, a breath of smoke, and that unmistakable toasted electronic smell. I have an IR thermography focused on the resistor, and its current temperature reads about 28 degrees Celsius. I'm going to clip the alligator leads onto the resistor. A single bright hotspot suddenly flares across its body, glowing hotter by the second until smoke begins to rise. The temperature rises to over 300 degrees Celsius. That's the classic signature of a resistor pushed past its thermal limit. It looks dramatic, but the truth is boring in the best way. Nothing mysterious failed. It just overheated. Here's a close-up of the 10-ohm resistor at the beginning of the experiment. And here it is again after being overheated. Here's the real story. A resistor's electrical power turns into heat. If the part can't shed that heat to the air fast enough, the temperature climbs until the material breaks down. Ohm's law says current equals voltage divided by resistance. Power equals voltage times current, which you can also write as V squared divided by R or I squared times R. In our demo, we applied 9 volts across a 10-ohm resistor. That means current equals 9 divided by 10 or 0.9 amps or 900 milliamps through that little cylinder. Multiply back for power, power equals 9 times 0.9 or 8.1 watts. We just asked a tiny 1/4 watt part to soak up more than 32 times its continuous rating. It functioned correctly. We turned it into a mini space heater. The 14 watt number tells you how much heat a resistor can safely handle continuously in cool, open air during a lab test. Real projects are tougher, especially inside a closed box with other warm parts. These resistors are also 10 ohms, but they're rated for half a watt. A 1/4 watt resistor is smaller, so it has less surface area and higher thermal resistance. It warms up faster and runs hotter at the same power. A half a watt resistor is larger, spreads heat through more material, and can dissipate it to the air more easily so it stays much cooler under the same load. Cooler parts live longer, drift less, and are less likely to brown nearby plastic or cook solder joints. You also usually get a higher working voltage and better surge tolerance with the half a watt. The trade-offs: it's bigger, needs more board space, and costs a bit more. When the air around the resistor reaches a temperature of about 70 degrees Celsius, the safe heat it can handle decreases. That drop is called derating. Heat rise depends on two things: how much power the part turns into heat, and how easily that heat can leave. A bigger body lets heat escape faster because it has more surface area to dump heat into the air and more material to spread the heat out, so no single spot gets too hot. This means a bigger resistor has lower thermal resistance and runs cooler at the same power. Also, don't mix up short bursts with steady use. Many resistors can take a quick, high-power spike for a tiny moment, but they can't survive that level non-stop. Datasheets include pulse curves, simple charts that show how big a burst and how long it can last before the part overheats. This is a stress test where the resistor is hit with short, high-energy electrical pulses, much higher than its continuous 1/4 watt rating. For a 10-ohm resistor, 1.0% is plus or minus 0.1 ohm. When you add 0.05 ohm, the total is plus or minus 0.15 ohm. Let's walk through a 9-volt LED setup like a pro. Say you're using a red LED that drops about 2 volts and you want around 20 milliamps. The resistor needs to handle the leftover voltage. 9 volts minus 2 volts equals 7 volts. Using R equals V divided by I, 7 volts divided by 0.02 amps equals 350 ohms. If you don't have a 350 ohm resistor, you can use the nearest value. For this setup, I'm going to use a 330 ohm resistor. With 330 ohms, the current is about 21 milliamps. Now check heat in the resistor. P equals V times I equals 7 volts times 0.021 amps approximately, 0.147 watts. A 1/4 watt part works on paper, but give yourself headroom. Choose a half a watt resistor so it runs cool and lasts longer, especially inside a case. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.